There's a book that they found at Nag Hammadi. It's called the Second Treatise of the Great Seth. That's what they called it. The Second Treatise of the Great Seth, which states very clearly that a man named Simon was crucified instead of Jesus. Very clearly. And there was a large group of Christians in the first century called the Basilidians. The Basilidians, who denied that Isa alayhi salam was crucified. Okay. Who is Simon? So if you read Matthew, Mark, and Luke in the New Testament, it says that when they were going to crucify Jesus, the Romans pulled a man out of the crowd named Simon, and they compelled him to bear the cross. Many Christians in the first century believed this man was crucified instead of Jesus. So in the Gospel of John, the last of the four Gospels in the New Testament, which is written around 100 of the Common Era, John says very clearly, Jesus bore his own cross. He doesn't even mention that episode of Simon, because he knows at his time, there were Christians who categorically denied that Isa alayhi salam was crucified.
We have no indication that he didn't die on the cross. We have no indication that he didn't die on the cross.
For most contemporary Christians, indeed for most inhabitants of the Western world, it's almost unthinkable that anyone could seriously maintain that Jesus was not crucified. Such critics of Islam might even maintain that the alleged resurrection of Jesus is a matter of religious belief. But the crucifixion of Jesus is a matter of an unblemished historical record.
Is absolutely beyond question.
One of the most certain events in all of history.
It is the unanimous written testimony.
However, as we shall soon see, the actual historical record is otherwise than we might expect. Outside of the New Testament and other early Jewish and Christian scriptural writings, there are only two references to Jesus being crucified in the entire historical record of the first and early second centuries. The first was made by Josephus ben Matthias, a first century Jewish historian, and the second by Tacitus, a first and second century Roman. Neither writer was present at the crucifixion event. For that matter, most biblical scholars maintain that none of the New Testament authors who wrote about the crucifixion event were actual witnesses to that event.
As I studied more and more using my intelligence, I became convinced that the New Testament Gospels were not written by eyewitnesses or by people who knew eyewitnesses.
In short, the discrepancy about the crucifixion event between Islam and contemporary Christianity obscures the fact that many branches of early Christianity maintain quite adamantly that it was not Jesus Christ who was crucified. This can be verified by examining the writings of the so-called apostolic fathers of the early Christian churches, the so-called New Testament Apocrypha, and even the New Testament itself. The writings of the apostolic fathers frequently noted that there were Christian sects that rejected the proposition that Jesus had been crucified. Such references can be found in the writings of Ignatius, Polycarp, Justin, Irenaeus, Tertullian, and Hippolytus. Together, these apostolic fathers represent a veritable who's who of early Christianity. As a specific example, we can turn to the Trallians, a book authored by Ignatius, the Bishop of Antioch, who died around the year 110. In referring to the crucifixion event, Ignatius wrote that there were Christians of his day who denied that Jesus was crucified in reality, but was crucified only in appearance or in illusion. In considering this statement from Ignatius, one must acknowledge that he could not be attacking a belief among Christians that did not, in fact, exist. His attack against those early Christians who believed that Jesus' crucifixion was only illusory demonstrates the existence of that belief among Christians at least as early as 110, the date of Ignatius' death. Further, the fact that Ignatius even bothered to attack this doctrine suggests that that belief was quite widespread by at least 110. The fact that many branches of early Christianity maintained that it was not Jesus Christ who was crucified can also be readily verified by considering the so-called New Testament Apocrypha. For example, the Apocalypse of Peter, 81 through 82, maintained that Jesus was crucified only in appearance, not in reality, with the one who was crucified being a substitute or simulacrum of Jesus. Likewise, the second treatise of the great Seth, 55 through 56, stated it was not Jesus who was crucified, but Simon, presumably Simon of Cyrene, who is identified in the biblical Gospels of Matthew, Mark, and Luke as being the person who carried Christ's cross for him. This position that it was Simon of Cyrene who was crucified in place of Jesus was a cardinal tenet of that early Christian group known as Basileans, which flourished in Egypt during the second century and which claimed to have received its message directly from Glaucus, the translator of Peter, one of the 12 disciples. Additionally, the Acts of John 97 through 101 reported that the crucifixion of Jesus was an illusion. However, it is not just within the so-called apocryphal writings that one finds evidence that it was not Jesus who was crucified. The biblical Gospel of Matthew, chapter 27, verses 11 through 26, tell us about Jesus being before Pontius Pilate.
So this name, Yeshua, it also has the ood. It's called Shurek in Hebrew. His name literally means the one saved by God. That's what his name literally means. Psalms 26. All right. This is what it says. It says, I know that God will save his Messiah. God will save his Messiah. He shall hear him from his holy heaven with the saving power of his right hand. Right? So this idea that Isa alayhi salam, that the Messiah wasn't crucified, this is not a Muslim invention. This has precedent in prophecy in the Old Testament.
وقولهم إنا قتلنا المسيح عيسى بن مريم رسول الله وما قتلوه وما صلبوه ولكن شبه لهم وإن الذين اختلفوا فيه لفي شك ما لهم به من علم إلا اتباع الظن وما قتلوه يقيناً